Hey guys, this is Meena and Dee from Pink Villa, back with yet another live, and I will wait till a few people join in and then we will tell you who we are going live with. So today we are going live with a beauty queen from TV who's also been a part of film industry and done a lot of successful films. And she's also a poker queen. I have been told that she loves playing poker. So today we are going to talk about everything. Her love for poker, TV, everything. So if you've guessed it, very good. If you've not, Anita Hasnandani is going live with us today. And please send in your questions. Whatever it is, we will definitely take them and I'll make sure that Anita answers your questions. Anita has... And now we will go live with Anita. I think Mera Swag Katega. Hello, how are you?
I'm very well. How are you? So nice to speak to you.
Oh, finally. We are meeting like this for a change.
I've seen all your interviews and all your chats and conversations. They are amazing. You're doing fab.
Thank you so much. Chalo, achha laga. So, Anita, how's quarantine and lockdown treating you? How are you? Are you getting used to it by now or are you like getting bored?
So there are some days which really, you know, bog me down. I get a little depressed, but I think everybody is going through the same phase. What is important is to stay safe and be home, which I'm doing. So yeah, otherwise it's just fine. And like we're here to discuss poker, quarantine is the best time because you know, you can play poker online and I've been killing it. I've been playing on Spartan.
Poker is not a very conventional sport to play. Where did you get introduced?
So I've always
been it's a getting a little drop. It's dropping a bit, but now I think it's fine.
Is my network bad?
I think you're getting stuck. I don't know, guys. Who's getting stuck?
So one second. Should I try something? Should I like put my Wi-Fi off or something? Oh, now it's fine. It's fine now?
Yeah, now it's fine. Now it's fine.
Okay. So yeah, basically all of Diwali's, usually we play cards. And I enjoy playing cards. It's in my blood literally. Or my family also, a lot of people play on Diwali. So that's how I started playing poker. You know, Harman Baweja, he introduced me to it. As in how to
really?
Play. Yeah. He's an amazing poker player. So he basically taught me a little bit here and there. And then honestly, once you start playing poker, it's pretty addictive, time consuming, and it obviously requires a lot of skill. So yeah, it's fun.
So how much of poker are you playing these days? Now that, you know, we are all at home, how many hours in a day are you playing? And Spartan is online, if I'm not wrong. So it's even better.
Exactly. So that's what I've been trying to say. I've been playing poker almost about 6 to 8 hours a day. So yeah, I really enjoy poker. And you know, the app Spartan, if you go online, it's just so simple and so easy to get connected and so easy to understand the format and how to play. So it's super exciting. And like I said, we all get bored at home. I mean, how much Netflix, how much of these shows, how much Alt Balaji, like all of that I've consumed and watched. But how much can you? You need some time doing something different. So I end up playing poker about 6 to 8 hours a day.
Does your husband also indulge in playing poker with you?
He doesn't understand anything. He's always sitting beside me and he's like, you know, I don't understand it, how, and you know, I try to teach him, but it takes a little time. Although once you get started, you really enjoy it. So not that he gets bothered with me playing poker, because the more poker I play, the more Netflix he gets to watch of what he wants to watch. So it's a win-win for both.
Yeah, that way it's a win-win for both. But what do you do to like improve your skills? Is there any way that you strategize or you think or you follow somebody or strategy to improve your skills at the game?
I mean, see, honestly, to improve your skill, it's really nice to play online because people can't see you, you know. So it gets a little more easier for you to try and brush up your skill. And if you're a newbie wanting to learn poker, then this app is perfect because it's, you know, they have buy-ins from really less to like really high, depending on whatever you want to play. And if you want to improve your skill, online is perfect because people can't see your face. They can't see your reaction. They can't notice your anxiety, nervousness or whatever. So I think of late, I've been playing so much poker online on Spartan that I feel I have become a slightly better player.
How much have you won? Like maximum that you've won and maximum that you've lost?
So, I've won like a couple of tournaments. So, basically, how much ever, like I've won, say, once, you know, I won about 5.5 lakhs. There was this tournament on Spartan where the buy-in was for 5,500. Okay. And then, but I had to play. It's like, you know, to play poker, you have to be really patient and really calm. And you have to, I mean, focus for many, many hours. I remember I started playing at 6 in the evening. And I got done at 6 in the morning, but I can't explain to you when I won the feeling. Oh my God, it felt really amazing because imagine you invest 5,500 and you win 5 lakhs. So true. That was my biggest win so far. And about losing, I prefer not to keep a track. It's better that way. It's enjoy your win and forget your losses. That's the funda.
So, do you love playing poker online or offline? Like, have you played offline as well?
Yes, I have. But like, I'm. It's been, say, about a year and a half. Abhishek Jalan is a pro player, so he taught me a little bit. He's coached me a little bit. So basically, I've played offline, but I'm still not that great because, you know, although I'm an actor, a little bit of anxiety or nervousness, the kind of person I am, it immediately shows. So I'm working on that. But on the other hand, on Spartan, I feel like a pro. I feel like I am making the most of this quarantine because I'm doing something. I'm learning a skill. I'm improving a skill. I'm improving something that I really love. So it's been fun.
And I love it on that. Yesterday, we spoke to India's female poker player, Nikita Luthor, and she saying there are not many women playing the game, and today the numbers are increasing. Do you think that there's been a shift in that department as well?
See, honestly, I feel whatever men can do, women can do a little better. Because women are more patient, more compassionate, more calm. And to be a good poker player, these are the few qualities that you need. So I think if a lot of women take it seriously, women can do way better in poker than men. And there are comparatively lesser women playing poker. But I would love to encourage via this chat or whatever that a lot of women should play because I'm sure we women will kill it.
Do you think, she also mentioned that there's been, for the longest time, there's been a social taboo attached to the sport. Do you think that is also going away with time? People are at least getting adapted and used to this?
Yeah, I mean, it's going to take a while. Although people do understand now that poker is a sport, it requires skill. Although a lot of people do think, oh my God, it's like Jua, it's gambling. But it's about doing everything in a limit, doing everything correctly. And the more you start playing, the more you'll understand it's not just about luck. It has a lot to do about which hand you play and how you play that particular hand. So it's definitely about skill. And dheere dheere, I think people are realizing that. And I'm sure, you know, people will evolve and realize and understand that poker is just a sport.
Also, the best thing is that, you know, in the last few years, you have literally climbed to the top with your performances. Now, when you're a good actor, does it become an advantage when you're bluffing? Like, does that come in handy? The power of acting?
Definitely, it does come in play. But as a person, I am very scared to lie. So I'm still getting, you know, I'm getting the hang of bluffing. I'm getting a little better at it day by day, but definitely being an actor definitely helps.
What are your poker plans for this year? Is there something that you want to do? Maybe in half of the year is gone almost, and God knows with Corona what happened, but is there a plan, maybe online?
Well, I don't mind taking... up a coaching... you know, a coaching lesson, like, you know, maybe on, like, the way we're chatting, people can teach poker. And if, like, I have a great teacher, I would love to coach and try and improve my skills. Because anyway, right now, we're not doing much. And since I love poker so much, I think that is one thing I could do, I would do, and I would probably get better at it.
Before we end the poker discussion, I have to ask you that if you were on a fantasy date, like a poker date with any of the actors, who would you pick? Like, if you had to go out to play poker with any actor?
That's the easiest question. I'm a crazy Salman Khan fan. Anybody and everybody knows that. Be it poker, be it anything, be it any fantasy, I want Salman Khan with me.
Lovely. Also, now I will take the question. A lot of people are talking about your stint in Nagin. Syed Danish Ali has said, favorite Nagin vamp. So I want to ask you that, you know, I recently interviewed Ekta Kapoor for a series that we did on Women's Day. It was called Woman Up. And in that conversation, or maybe in Bhavna's conversation, she said that she, when she was planning Nagin, not many actresses, and she wanted to make it as a film, not many actors believed in the project. And today, Nagin has completely changed the way people look at TV. You know, it's something that people wait for, and it's the highest rated show since it started. What do you have to say? Do you see the paradigm shift in people's outlook? I'm sure you are Ekta's good friend, so you would know that she was planning it as a film. So when she came to you, what was your first reaction?
I mean, honestly, I feel Ekta is best, and she knows the best. I mean, not only in Nagin, even when she casted me in Ye Hai Mohabbate, even that was negative. So she just has the perfect eye of who fits in where, and she just knows what works with the audience and what doesn't. So maybe people would have been in two minds whether something like this will work. Oh my God, film hai, TV ban raha hai. I truly feel that Ekta just knows the pulse of the audience.
True.
She understands them so well. I mean, imagine every season of Nagin is a super hit. I did Ye Hai Mohabbate for over 6 years, and people loved it from the beginning to the end. So I think it's all because of Ekta. She is just amazing at what she does, and which is why when she came, when I was approached, like, not even for a second did I blink my eye. Not even for a second did I think, oh my God, negative hai, villain hai. I just trust her, you know, instinct, and trust what she thinks for me so much that I just blindly said yes. And I think these few decisions are the best decisions I've made in my life.
Listen, I don't want to give it out, but I am a huge fan of, I am a sucker for films like Krishna Cottage and Kuch Toh Hai. I can watch it any time. I'm not even kidding. And we were watching Kuch Toh Hai, me and my cousin sister, we are staying. So we are watching Kuch Toh Hai last week, and talking about it, you played a villain in Kuch Toh Hai so brilliantly.
Really? Like,
yeah, of course. And also, a lot of people talking about Ye Hai Mohabbate, a lot of people, Shruti XX has asked, so first she said that, hello ma'am, I'm a big fan of yours and you're just amazing. And the question she's asked is, which festival shoot in Ye Hai Mohabbate was special for you and why?
Which, what shoot?
Festival shoot.
Oh, I mean, all the festivals that I've shot on Ye Hai Mohabbate have been grand. But there's one scene that I remember that has nothing to do with festivals. That was the first time on TV I was playing drunk. I had to be drunk and I had to take off on Ishita, that's Divyanka's character. I think that is one of my most memorable scenes. Being a villain, I did that and I got so many messages saying, oh my God, you were so cute. I mean, instead of people saying, oh my God, you were so bitchy, I got messages saying that they loved it and that I was so cute in that scene. So that is one of my most memorable scenes of Yeh Mohabbate. And as far as festivals go, they've all been shot so grandly. I've enjoyed every.
True. How is it working with them? Are you still in touch with all your co-stars from Yeh Mohabbate?
Absolutely. I'm very close to Aditi. I'm very close to Neena ji, to Karan. So everybody knows, you know, we share a bond that goes back decades. So yeah, I'm very much in touch with them. They're a family and we still do your calls, WhatsApp calls, FaceTime. And yeah. And I really miss shooting with them and I really love them.
You know, in this time of the lockdown, everybody is on those apps playing games. And I was seeing Ekta was there one of the days when she put out that whole picture with all of you. So how has it been like catching up in a different way? How do you see it?
You know, it is strange, but the most amazing part about this lockdown, I don't know if you think the same, but is that you're more in touch with people you love via FaceTime and WhatsApp call. I mean, I wouldn't speak to Ekta so much for so many days, but now every day we're on a call, you know, we're more connected. And for, like, I'm not staying with my mom. So, you know, even with my mom, she's like, when I'm shooting, so obviously, kabhi hum FaceTime nahi karte, kabhi hum WhatsApp call nahi karte. Like, now, in a day, at least three times I FaceTime my mom to see if she's okay. And I think it's created a different bond altogether.
True.
So one good thing has come out of this is that the bonds have definitely gotten stronger.
That is true. Were you shooting for anything when this lockdown happened?
I was shooting for Nagin until the last second.
So, is there any plan? Like, have you discussed with the team, like, when this will come back? When are you planning to get back on the sets? Is there a plan to...
I don't think anyone has an idea, to be honest. Everybody's priority right now is to, you know, get over this nicely, like a big, you know, like I think if we all do the bit that we're supposed to do of staying home and staying safe and not stepping out, I think that is what is the most important and that's the priority right now for everybody. So work has definitely completely taken a backseat. But there's one very interesting, I don't know if I'm allowed to talk about it, but I am there. So Balaji is making an interesting series where everybody is going to shoot from home. So I am obviously a part of it. So I'm super excited. So people will get their dose of entertainment via Balaji because they are the best at it.
So it's a web series. It's like a series or is it only a video like we are seeing like a lot of people shot?
Even I'm not too sure, but I'm going to figure it out where they're going to air it. But it's definitely, it involves a lot of actors and it's everybody's going to shoot differently from their rooms and homes. So yeah, it's going to be an exciting snippet or show or series, whatever it is.
Absolutely. What is the first thing that you will do once this lockdown ends?
Go and give a tight hug to my mom, because honestly, you know, I am somebody, I have a little cough and cold round the year because I drink cold water, I drink Diet Coke. So, you know, I don't know about others, but I'm super paranoid. So even if I go and say hi to my mom, she lives 2 minutes away. I'm like, just stay far away from me. Even Rohit, I'm like, just stay far away from me. So definitely I'm going to hug, give tight hugs to my loved ones and just let them know that how much I love them and how, you know, this whole thing has made us realize that how important family is, how important your life is and yeah. So yeah, I think I'm going to hug my loved ones.
Somebody, Priyanka Nanda Nai. Six has asked, will you ever be part of a show like Big Boss?
No. Even if I do, I'll be the first one to get out. So, I'm not afraid.
Maybe just for But you can meet Salman sir anyway. You don't need to do a Big Boss for Salman.
But honestly, I would actually, the only reason if I would do Big Boss even for a week would be so that I could spend that weekend with Salman via the TV screen.
But you know, is there any other project apart from Nagin that you are in talks for, which you are going to do once lockdown ends? Maybe a web series. Are you looking at web series also?
I'm doing a romantic series with Alt Balaji. And it's a beautiful script, beautiful story. And I think... It's once the lockdown ends, I think it's going to... start almost in like 10-15 days. So I'm super excited about that. It's not titled yet. And then I've completed a film with Tushar, which again, I can't talk much about it. So that is going to be out. So yeah, some exciting things are on the way.
Oh, so kuch toh hai, team is back.
Yes.
I think you should do a sequel to Kuch Toh Hai, because I think that is one of the films that I really love. I don't know how much I love, but I genuinely, I can watch it any time of the day. It's a cool film. And before going, I want to ask you that, you know, so many seasons of Nagin has happened, right? And we have had actresses play Nagin or any other characters all over in the last 4 seasons. I want to know that, is there a plan to put in a season? Like, you know how Avengers, everybody comes together? Is there a plan to put that in place where so many people come together?
Well, I think it would be really exciting. It's a great idea. But I am nobody to, you know, quote on that. But I would definitely love it if that happened. And I just hope that Ekta gets this idea. In fact, I'll discuss it with her. It'll be fabulous to have all the Nagins in one season. And I think even people would really enjoy it.
You know, also coming back to poker, do you remember the first game you played? Like, did you win? Did you lose? Were you nervous? Were you anxious? You said that Arman Baveja was introduced to poker. So that happened around 6 years ago.
Yeah, so basically it's beginner's luck. The first time you play, you always win. So that's my memory that Harman taught me a little bit here and then. I was just randomly playing. I was not using any skill, obviously. I was just going with my gut and I went all in and all of that and I was winning. So yeah, my memory is that obviously you get addicted and you want to know more about the sport when you win. So yeah, my first time I really won, which is what got me excited. I was like, I want to learn more, I want to do more, I want to get better.
But anyone from your friends group who you have taught the game or who's also interested in the game?
A little bit to Aditi. I've introduced poker to her. And Karan and Ali anyway enjoy it. They too play poker. Mubeen Saudagar is a great poker player too. So a lot of TV actors actually do play poker. And yeah, I've definitely taught Aditi a little bit of poker and even a little bit to Krishna. Because there would be many a times I would be on Spartan and they would be like, what are you doing? I'm like, I'm playing poker. So yeah, I've taught them a little bit.
So technically, how many hours do you give to Spartan on a normal day? Like not during lockdown? But on a normal day, because I think that's they also come up with championships and stuff, so you have participated in the championships as well?
Correct. Yeah, that's what tournaments is what I've usually played. And when you're playing a tournament, you have to dedicate about 8 to 10 hours because it's a long run tournament. So once you start, you have to stick by it. So every Sundays they have some great tournaments. So even when I was shooting, I would end up playing once a week and dedicating that one Sunday to poker. A, because I enjoy it. B, because I wanted to get better. So yeah, every Sunday I've been playing for the past, I think, 2.5-3 years. On Spartan.
But have you ever thought of taking it up as an alternate part-time thing? Like, it's also a profession that way.
Before the time khatam nahi hua, toh wahi karna padega.
इसी बीच में कितने सारे गेम खेल लिए
मैं हर रोज खेलती हूँ, उनके पास हर रोज अलग अलग टूर्नामेंट्स होते हैं, बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग होते हैं, तो मैं हर रोज 8 घंटे तो पोकर खेलती ही खेलती हूँ.
You know, something that Nikita said yesterday was very beautiful. He said that, you know, people think that, is it intimidating to be a woman on a table with so many men? And she said that it's more than me. I think the men are more intimidated and they don't even, they're shy to look at me. And that's why they can't gauge my reaction and that helps me.
Absolutely. She's absolutely right. The men get a little like you go all in and they're like wondering what just happened. It's you know, we actually, because we are fewer, we have an upper hand. And like men are embarrassed to, like she said, that, you know, stare at you or, you know, try to gauge what you're thinking or what's going on. So we definitely, when we play on a table, we do have an upper hand.
If you had to bring up your fondest memory related to the sport, like something that you thought you might not be winning and you suddenly won, or maybe you won a lot of money, which one would it be?
I think the first tournament I won on Spartan, it was the 5,500 where I won 5 lakhs. I couldn't believe it. I was so excited. And I actually was like, this is real money. Am I actually going to get it? And when I received it, I was like on cloud 9. And that's when I decided, okay, but honestly, money, toh, okay, you know, you win and all. But the journey, the hands you play, how you play, is what is more exciting. Because when you play a hand correctly, you just feel so proud and it's just so nice.
You know, has poker, playing poker, changed you in any way? Like you said that you need and require a lot of patience, a lot of concentration. Do you think it has changed you internally in any way?
Sorry, come again?
I'm saying that, you know, the game needs a lot of concentration and patience from a player. And since you've been playing it for so many years, do you think that from the time you started playing poker, there have been some changes in you as a person also?
Definitely, I've become more patient, more raw. And you know, there are days when you're not running good, you're not getting the best hands. So you realize that in time, and you're okay with it because you understand, okay, things aren't going the way you expected to, which is fine. So you play another day. But definitely my patience level has improved. And yeah, I've become more calmer because you have to be really calm on a table. So I have become a lot more calmer. And my friend Mushtaq just messaged saying also talk about the housey. So we've also been playing housey and it's been super fun.
So I want to ask you that, has there ever been like, so you guys are playing, do you guys play poker during Diwali or like when you meet at Ekta Kaam?
Yeah, very much.
Does Ekta also join you guys? Does Ekta love playing poker?
She doesn't like to play poker, but she enjoys Teen Patti, the three-card flash.
Yeah. So, I want to ask you that, you know,
Raj Kundra plays a lot of poker and he's really good.
Yeah, Shilpa Shetty also. Nikita was telling
me. Yeah.
So, you played with them also?
Yes.
You know, has there been one person who you thought was a great player and you beat them? And you were very happy?
I've played with really good players, like with pros. So, there are two of my friends. One is Nikunj, who is a brilliant player, and off late also we've been playing. So whenever I win a hand from him, it feels really good. And also Abhishek Jalan, like these two are my pro poker players that I look up to, Abhishek Jalan and Nikunj Junjunwala. So whenever I am stuck or whenever I'm in two minds, what to do or what move should I make, I call them. Map, and they're my go-to poker buddies.
And one person who defeated you among all your friends, and then you were shocked, like you thought that, oh, maybe they are not
Ali Goni. I did not expect him to be a great a poker player. I was really underestimating him. But when I was playing with him, I was like, oh my God, like one or two hands, he got them right, he won. I was like, oh my God. Okay, so we do have a lot of good poker players in the industry.
True. Before we go, I want to ask you that, you know, a lot of people do not still think of poker as a profession. It's also a profession which is helping a lot of people changing their life. Like Nikita Luther's life has completely changed because of the poker that she said. You're still an actress and you love playing poker. Do you think that more and more people should inculcate the habit of playing, or maybe at least learning the sport, or maybe even thinking of it as a profession? Do you think that that change should come? Or
well, definitely.
There are courses outside.
People should definitely take up courses, take it as a sport, learn it, and obviously poker is something that you have to play in the right frame of mind in a limit and understand that it's a sport, and you know you're supposed to, like, there you won't believe it, and no, nor would people, but on Spartan I have played tournaments of 100 rupees, you know, so like the smallest tournament, because poker is not only about winning and not only about money. It's a skill and the pleasure that you get when you play the hand right. It's about playing that hand skillfully, and it's not about whether you're playing for 100 rupees or whether you're playing for 2 lakhs. So definitely they should take it up. They should learn. It could definitely make a great profession, but yeah, I I'm not even close to switching my profession. I'm really, I love acting way too much, but definitely free time is my poker time, and I really enjoy it.
Thank you so much. It's always lovely. And I don't know, there's a sense of happiness when we meet and when we talk, because
absolutely,
there's so much positivity and warmth. And I hope this lockdown ends soon and we are safe and healthy and we meet and we catch up and we do something super fun.
Sounds like a plan. Good luck, and you stay home, stay safe, say hi to Bhavna. And
I will.
And this was super exciting. Thank you so much.
We'll do something super soon also with you.
Done.
Bhavna
done,
will
done,
hopefully
done.
Get it done. Thank you so much, Anita. It was lovely.
Same here. Bye.
Bye.
Can I just share the entire chat? No, then I'll repost it on my...
Yeah, I will. I will. I will. Immediately.
Okay. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.
See you. Bye.
See you. See you.